In photography, the term tonal range, also sometimes referred to as dynamic range, is used to describe the quality of color and tone within an image, ranging from the darkest to the brightest areas and everything in between. In digital photography, the tonal range of an image is dependent on the dynamic range of the sensor capturing that image. It should be noted, however, that it is not difficult to capture a full tonal range of black to white. The challenge comes in representing the tones in between, which bring detail and texture to an image or even a scene that you shoot with your digital camera. Hang on to the end of this video because I'm going to explain tonal range and how it differs from dynamic range and how you can use it to improve your work. Hi, my name is Jim Costa. I'm a full-time working photographer, video producer, video editor, and technology pro. If you like what you see in this video, stick around to the end because I've got a couple of photography, video, filmmaking, and editing freebies, and even some training courses that I'll tell you about that will definitely help improve your work and help grow your business through earned media exposure. You can help support my channel by purchasing my training courses, requesting my free downloads, and even hiring me. Remember, I welcome your comments, questions, and more on all of my videos. If you like what you see, subscribe to my channel and hit that bell to be notified every time I upload a new video on Wednesdays. I've also done many other videos on improving your photography work. I'll link to those in the description below for you as well. Before I can explain what tonal range is, I need to explain what dynamic range is because it directly affects tonal range. So what is dynamic range? In its simplest form, photography is the capturing of light, and light is made up of photons from the sun. Dynamic range is the difference in light between the brightest value and the darkest value that the camera can capture. The human eye can see 24 different stops of light from the highlights to the shadows. Cameras, however, only make instantaneous exposures, with film and expensive medium format digital cameras being able to capture 12 different stops of light variations, while most other digital cameras can only capture about 5 stops of light variations or even less. One of the many important things that sensor size affects is the dynamic range of the digital camera. This is why it is sometimes better to have a larger sensor with a lower resolution than to have a smaller sensor with a higher resolution. This has to do with the size of the pixels on the sensor that are used to collect light. In every pixel, there is a small pit called a photosite that measures photons, which are the little bundles of energy in which light travels, to determine how bright or dark something is. So, the larger the photosite, the more photons it can measure. If a scene is too bright, then the number of photons a photosite will need to measure from the dark areas is very small, so it will be able to accommodate them all. However, for the bright areas, there are more photons than the photosites will need to measure. So the smaller a photosite is in size, the more quickly it becomes saturated. Think of it like this. You have two glasses, one very large and one very small. If you put water in the glasses, which glass is going to fill up first? Obviously the small one. The photosites work the same way. A smaller photosite means it can only capture fewer photons, so it's going to fill up first, and then you have a problem. This means that it hits a white point, and all the highlights get blown out much faster than it would with a larger size photosite, which would give your camera a larger dynamic range. Another solution would be to measure for the highlights. We would have greater highlight details, but then our shadows will be with no detail at all and represented as too dark or even black. In pictures, we'd call that being muddy, which means that there's not enough light in the dark sections. With that, let's take a look at tonal range. In photography, tonal range refers to mid-tone value expanding to occupy the scale between the lightest and darkest points of an image. The wider the range expands, the more contrast there is and the more mid-tone values would be represented in the image. An image with a narrow tonal range would cover a more restricted area between its lightest and darkest values, thus mainly consisting of mid-tones and in turn having less contrast. The histogram gives gives us a really good idea about the tonal range of an image on a scale of 0 to 255. The white point, the point on the rightmost side of the scale, has a value of 255 and is purely white. The black point, the point on the left-hand side of the scale, has a value of 0 and is purely black, as well as a number of points in between pure black and pure white that constitute the midtones, you know, all the numbers between 1 and 254. If the tone gradation between successive midtone values was smooth, with no areas with absent values, the tonal separation would be continuous and you would have an image with smooth transitions where the brightness appears consistent and uninterrupted from one value to the next. If, however, there were blank areas between successive midtone values on a histogram, this would yield a visible stepping of shades in a gradient, constituting graduated colors that break into larger blocks of a single color, reducing the smooth look of a proper gradation. A rich range of tones in a colored as well as a black and white image is vital to success. In digital photography, this is limited to the sensor's dynamic range and its ability to capture wide enough distribution of tones that would be considered suitable for the purpose of the photo. Factors that influence the tonal range of the final image include subject reflectance as well as the lighting. A high reflectance subject accompanied by high lighting results in a long span of image tones that are probably beyond the sensor's capability. Also, light size and quality, harsh or soft, also control the tonal range of a scene. So do special effect filters, such as polarizing filters, that are known to increase color vibrancy and expand the tonal range. Diffusers and similar light-controlled equipment lessen contrast, thus reducing the overall tonal range. The bit depth used to encode an image has an effect on the tonal range of that image. 8 bits yield 256 discrete levels of information, which is the minimum number of levels that produces visually continuous tones, while 16 bits yield 65,536 discrete levels of information, and thus a better tonal range. Now, if this is making sense to you, but I've got it in the comments section below. My question of the day is, how have you used tonal range to improve the images that you shoot? Leave a comment below and let us know. If you found the information in this video useful, I'd love to hear about it from you. If you liked it and want to see more videos like this, then follow my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films. If you think what you saw was great, please like it. If you have an opinion, feel free to comment below. If you know someone who could benefit from the information I provided, please share the video. You can connect with me and my company, Jim Costa Films, on social media and online, on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, and the web by searching for Jim Costa Films. In fact, I currently have over 4,470 videos on my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, so feel free to check out many of my other videos for great tips and suggestions. Thank you for sticking around this long. I mentioned at the beginning about some freebies and training. As a professional video producer and photographer, I've created an absolutely free cheat sheet for you on all the best camera settings to shoot with your DSLR, mirrorless, or video camera that will show you the settings that will allow your photos, and particularly your videos, to shine and stand out from the competition. The link to get that cheat sheet is just below in the video description. Best of all, my cheat sheet specializes in shooting video with any type of camera. In it, you'll find all the info you need on important video techniques, such as white balance, color temperature, frame rates, and more. I've also created an editing training for Adobe Premiere Pro. My quick start training is designed to get you up and editing video in under 2 hours, and includes over 100 tips, tricks, and keyboard shortcuts to help video editors. And now, I'm also affiliated with Christina Nicholson, a fellow media veteran like myself, who helps businesses and entrepreneurs reach tons of their ideal customers or clients through the power of media without spending big bucks on advertising. I've worked with Christina and used her advice and training successfully, so I know from firsthand experience that it works great. The program Christina and I are now offering is called the Media Mentoring Program, and it will help you take advantage of mainstream media so you can stand out from the competition, because it's not something everyone has access to. Best of all, unlike paid ads and sponsorships, you can gain lots of exposure and credibility to become the go-to brand everyone talks about and wants to do business with without spending a fortune on advertising. I'll link to those cheat sheets and training courses in the description below as well. There's videos on both courses that will give you an overview of how they can help you. If you follow me for a while now, you may know that I have a private community of photographers and videographers and filmmakers just like you on Facebook, where I share other pro tips and tricks. It's called Video Producers and Content Creators. I love new members who want to share their work, learn from others, and also help others. You'll find the link to the group in the description below, so feel free to join the group where you can learn even more.